Now, we are going to discuss what is a symmetric tensor. In the elements of a contravariant vector of rank 2 satisfying the equation Aij is equal to Aji. So here Aij is equal to Aji. Now the index is interchanged. I is changed to J, J is changed to I. So they are interchanging of indices. Then this, if Aij is equal to Aji, then Aij is said to be a symmetric tensor of contravariant rank 2. Similarly, for a covariant tensor of rank 2, the symmetric tensor is defined as Aij, the covariant, the indices Ij is in the covariant position. If it is equal to Aji, again we are interchanging the indices. If Aij is equal to Aji, then this is a, called as a symmetric tensor. This is a covariant tensor. Covariant tensor, and this is also a symmetric tensor. Now, suppose for a tensor of higher rank, now this is a tensor of higher rank, a contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank 2. Now here, if Aijk, Ijk is in the contravariant position and Jlm is in the covariant position, so the total rank is 5, contravariant rank 3, covariant rank 2. Now you are interchanging the indices J and K. So, and you are interchanging the indices J and K. So this is AKJ. Then the tensor is said to be symmetric with respect to the indices J and K. So this is a symmetric tensor with respect to the indices. You have to say indices J and K. Then now let us discuss what is meant by anti-symmetric tensor. What is the anti-symmetric tensor? Now again here let us consider a contravariant tensor Aij, contravariant position, the rank 2. Or if you consider, you can consider covariant tensor of rank 2. Ij is in the covariant position. The indices are in the covariant position. Now this is said to be anti-symmetric. So this is said to be anti-symmetric. If the elements satisfy Aij, so once if you interchange, you will get a negative sign. Very simple. So once if you interchange I and J, you will get a negative sign. For a symmetric tensor, it is a, there is no change of sign. Here, there is a only positive. In equation 2 is Aij is equal to Aji, but in equation 4, Aij is equal to minus Aji. Similarly, for a covariant tensor, if Ij, if you interchange, again you will get a covariant tensor with a negative sign. If it is so, then this tensor is, can be called as an anti-symmetric tensor. Now, this for a higher order rank, so a tensor of higher rank, here the rank 3, contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank 2, Lm, Ijk, Lm. Now, if you interchange any two indices, suppose if you interchange K and J, then, so if you interchange K and J, so this is a JK and this is KJ. If you get a negative sign, this is a negative sign. The tensor is anti-symmetric with respect to the indices J and K. Now, let us discuss some examples relevant to this symmetric tensor. Now, let us consider a simple problem. If Aij xi xj is 0. So you consider this equation. For all values of the variables, x1, x2, x3, because I runs from 1 to n in the n-dimensional space, j runs from 1 to n. So for all values of the variables, x1 to xn, then show that alm plus aml is equal to 0. So now we have to show this one. For this, now let us consider this the given equation. Given equation is aij is equal to xj is equal to 0. Here this is ij is in the covariant position. Here this I and j, xi and xj. So these are the coordinates. Now let us differentiate this equation 1 with respect to some xl. So if we differentiate this expression, aij, so this is keep xi is the first term, and you have to differentiate the second term, partial dxj by partial dxl plus aij. You differentiate this first quantity, partial dxi by dxl, xj is equal to 0, just uv form. U dv plus v du. So you just you keep xi and differentiate the second factor xj, and so you will get a partial dxj by dxl, and differentiate the first factor partial dxi by dxl, and xj is equal to 0. So if you differentiating with respect to xl, you will get this equation. Now what is the meaning of this expression? This is equal to delta jl. Because this is a JL. If both are equal, it is 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. So this is your Kronecker delta JL. Similarly, this expression is again partial delta IL. Because this is again a Kronecker delta. So we will get equation 2. Then, so if you remove the Kronecker delta, so you will get AIL is equal to XI plus ALJ in XJ is equal to which is equal to 0. So this is equation 3. So you will get this expression. So if you use the property of Kronecker delta, you will get the equation 3. Now differentiate again the equation 3 with respect to xm. We get, so you differentiate this expression. For AIL, here if you differentiate this, you will get partial dxi by dxm. And this is ALJ. So here you have to differentiate this other factor is partial dxj by dxm. This is 0. Again, this is a Kronecker delta im. Here this is again a Kronecker delta j. Only when j and m are equal, this is a non-vanishing value. Here I m, m are equal, it is a non-vanishing value. So if you make this is equal, I is equal to m, so this index I may be replaced by m. This is so this non-vanishing quantity. Here j is equal to m, so j must be replaced by m, so this must be m. So aml plus alm is equal to 0, or of our convenience, you write ALM plus AML is equal to 0 equation 5. So this is the proof. Now let us consider another example. If AI and BJ, AI this is a contravariant vector, this is a covariant vector, are the components of a contravariant covariant tensor of rank 1. Show that this product AIBJ, which is equal to CIJ. So these are the components of the mixed tensor of rank 2. So in order to establish this relation, we have to use the transformation relation. So A alpha bar is equal to partial D X alpha bar by partial D XI here AI. So this is according to the definition of the contravariant vector. So the transformation relation is A alpha bar is equal to partial dx alpha bar with partial dx A. A alpha bar is the component of the contravariant vector in the bar system. AI is the components of the contravariant vector in the covariant in the unbarred system. So in the unbarred system and the barred system, they are related by this expression. Similarly, if we take B beta bar, so here this is a covariant vector. So B beta bar, so this is related by the transformation relation partial dxj by dx beta bar dj. So this is a, we have already defined the covariant and contravariant tensor. So according to this definition, we can write A alpha bar, this is a contravariant tensor of rank 1, and this is again d beta bar is equal to partial dxj by dx beta bar dj. So this is a covariant vector of rank 1. So this is equation 6. Then, so this is equation 6, we have of time. Then let us multiply this A alpha bar and beta bar. So if you multiply A alpha bar and beta bar, then you write down the transformation expression partial dx alpha bar by partial dx A, partial dx A by dx beta bar from equation 7. And you write the Aij Bj at the end of the transformation relation. So you can write down this transformation expression at any position. So you can interchange or you can take Ai at the end of this transformation equation. So you will get the equation 7. So this is now look at this transformation expression. So this is your transformation relation. The transformation relation tells you the nature of the tensor. So the transformation equation here, one alpha bar is in the numerator and beta bar is in the x beta bar is the denominator. So it must be a mixed tensor. So it must be a mixed tensor, alpha bar beta bar. So this product A alpha bar beta bar must be C alpha beta bar. So this from the transformation relation you can see that this product is a mixed tensor with contravariant rank alpha and contravariant rank 1, covariant rank 1. So this superscript is alpha and the subscript is beta. So this is the covariant position, alpha is the contravariant position. And also from this here I and J, here there is an I and J. So one, so this is this must be the A I B J, because here once it is in the superscript and here it is I, the summation will vanish because this is a dummy index. J is also a dummy index. So you can easily check. So from the transformation relation tells you that this product is a mixed tensor of rank 2, contravariant rank 1 and covariant. So AI BJ must be only CGI. So this must be. So if you write down the transformation for this mixed tensor CIJ, the transformation relation is this. So equation 8 will be transformation relation for the mixed tensor of CIJ. So here the transformation relation is like this. So you compare 7 and 8. You will notice that this Cij must be only AiBj, and C alpha bar beta C alpha beta bar must be A bar beta bar. So the transformation relation is very much important. That tells you about your the type of tensor. Now let us take one more example. Now prove that Cijlkm, which is equal to Aijk, this is a contravariant rank 2, covariant rank 1, BLM, contravariant rank 1, covariant. So this product, so the final tensor is equal to Cijl, so contravariant rank 3, covariant rank. So that we have already discussed. Now, so that this is a tensor, if a I j k and b l m. So if a I j k is a tensor and b l m is a tensor, this is a contravariant rank 1, covariant rank 1. This is b l m is a contravariant rank 1, covariant rank 1. Once if you make an outer product, you will get the final tensor is a mixed is a tensor of contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank. For this first you choose a I j k. This is a I j k. So this is a tensor in the unbound coordinate system. You write down the tensor in the bound coordinate system, a bar alpha beta bar. These two components are related by this transformation, partial dx alpha bar by dxi, partial dx beta bar by dxj, partial dxk by partial dx gamma bar. So this transformation relation is a is for the components of the tensor and the bar and unbar system. Similarly, you take another tensor BLM. This is a tensor of contravariant rank 1 and covariant rank 1, and B rho sigma bar is the tensor of contravariant rank 1 covariant rank 1 in the bar system. So this is unbar system. BLM is the component of the tensor in the unbar system. B rho sigma bar is the component of the tensor in the bar system. These two are related by this transformation, partial dx rho bar by partial dxl, partial dxm by partial dx sigma bar. So this is equation 9. So equation 9 is the transformation relation between the components of vectors in the bar and bar unbar coordinates. Now let us multiply this one, a alpha beta gamma bar and b rho sigma bar. You multiply these two quantities. So first write down the transformation relation first. Partial dx alpha bar by partial dxi, partial dx beta bar by partial dxj, partial dx k by partial dx gamma bar, partial d rho dx rho bar by divided by partial dxl, partial dxm by partial dx sigma bar. So first you write down the transformation relation. At the end you write down the components of the tensor, a I j k and b l. Now before finding the nature of the product, you look down the transformation relation. That as you already mentioned, the transformation relation tells you about the type of the tensor, that is whether what is whether it is a contravariant or covariant. If it is contravariant, what is the rank? If it is covariant, it is the rank. So that can be determined only from the transformation relation. So here alpha beta rho, so there are three indices in the contravariant position, and gamma sigma, there are two indices in the covariant position for a tensor in the bar system. So the final product must be this, must also, so this must be, what is this, the final product must be alpha beta rho gamma sigma bar. So this is because of 3 plus 2 5, 1 2 3, and this is 4 and this is 5. So 3 contravariant rank, 4 in rank. So from this transformation relation we can also note down I J L. So if we here there is no I J and L, the 3 indices in the numerator, contravariant position, and KM. So here there is an M here, and there is a K here. So one K here and M here. So this must be I J K B L M. So this product must be a tensor whose contravariant rank is 3, and the indices are I J L. So this I J L is the in the superscript, K is in the subscript. So this is a contravariant rank 3 and covariant rank. So the final tensor, once if we take tensors and if you multiply from the transformation relation, suggests that this transformation relation is for a tensor whose contravariant rank is 3 and covariant rank. So this can be easily pro. So this is the product. So if you multiply A I J K B L M, the product is C, and you write down I J L in the numerator. So I J L in the, so in the subscript, superscript, and K M in the subscript. So this is a K M. So this is a covariant position, and this is a contravariant position. Now let us take another example. If A I J K, so this is a tensor, contravariant rank 2, covariant rank 1. B L M, a contravariant rank 1, covariant rank 1. These two are tensors. This is given. Then show that A I J K and B J M is not a tensor. Here you see here is J. So both in the, there are indices are equal in the superscript. So the contravariant position. So there are I J. This here I J K. Here J is in the contravariant position. Another vector J is in the contravariant position. So the two indices are same indices in the contravariant position. So the two indices are same in the contravariant position, it will not be a tensor that we can establish. So first you write down I J K. So and you can write down the transformation relation. This is the components of the tensor in the Baud system, and the AIJK is the components of the tensor in the unbaud system. Similarly, if you consider BLM, BLM is a tensor. If it is a tensor, then B beta sigma bar is also a tensor. That can be also written like this, because this is a transformation relation. Now let us multiply these two, A alpha beta gamma bar and B beta sigma. If you multiply, you write on the transformation relation. The transformation relation here, this transformation relation you can write down. And this is the first three terms, and this is another two relations. This is your second term. So this is the final transformation relation. And here A I J K B L. Now just you can rearrange like this. The first term is like this, and the second term, the third term in that expression can be written like the second term, and here this term can be written like here, and finally you collect these two, dx beta bar here and here dx beta bar. So you keep this side by side. Now you write down this, you express this within the bracket. Now the two indices are in the numerator. This is a partial dx beta bar, partial dx beta bar. There is a, you cannot, there is no general method to evaluate the summation, because once a beta is present, dummy indices are present, that means there is a summation according to say Einstein summation convention. So beta identical indices, therefore there must be a summation, but there is no general method to evaluate the summation of this form. So you cannot do a summation of this form. Only if one index must be in the numerator and the another identical index must be in the denominator, then only you can perform a summation. Suppose if beta here, instead of beta here, if beta is in the denominator, you can perform a summation. But here both here beta as well as here beta, both are in the numerator position, so you cannot evaluate a summation. So there is no general method, that is important. There is no general method to evaluate a summation. So the transformation is not tensorial in character. So this is not a tensorial type of transformation. Since it is not a tensorial type of transformation, this is a product, both indices are equal, or in this product here J and J, both indices are equal in the contravariant position, then this is not a tensor. That is important. Now let us take another example. If we take a vector AI and BI, there are two vectors, one contravariant and the other covariant. So this is a contravariant vector AI, BI is a covariant vector. Now let us find the product. AIBI, which is invalid. So we have to show this is invalid. So in order to prove this result, first write down AI and express the components in the Baad system by the transformation relation. Here BI is a covariant vector. You express its component in the Baad system. So by the definition of the contravariant vector as well as covariant vector, you can write down this relation. Then let us multiply. If you multiply AI and BJ from the previous result, this transformation relation becomes A alpha bar B theta bar. Now here both indices are equal. We have put alpha is equal to B. Very simple. If you put alpha is equal to alpha, then that transformation relation, this becomes alpha, and here this beta, the beta must be replaced by alpha because both are equal. If it is alpha, this becomes Kronecker delta, delta ji, aibj. This term is a non-vanishing value. Only when I is equal to j, therefore this result is aib. So this is a product of the contravariant vector and the covariant vector in the unbarred system, and a alpha bar and beta alpha bar is the corresponding component of the vector in the barred system. So this is expression in the barred system, and this is expression in the unbarred system. If both values are equal, then you can say so the value of AIB is unaltered by the transformation of coordinates. So the system is invariant. So this is invariant because whether it is the product is expressed in the unbarred system or whether the product is expressed in the barred system, both are equal. So the AIBI is invariant. Now let us take another example. If phi is equal to Aij, AIAJ, we can always write phi is equal to Bij, AIAJ, where Bij is a symmetric term. So that is simple. So this is given. This we have to prove it. So now the given value is phi is equal to Aij, AIAJ. So this is given. Now I, they are repeated in this. One is in the lower position, one is in the higher position. So if it is so, and the indices are repeated, then they are called as a dummy indices. Dummy index may be replaced by any other index. Whether it is I, what is the meaning of I? I runs from 1 to n in n dimension. So A1j, A1, aj plus A2j, A2, AJ and so on. Even if we replace I by some other index, say L, again L runs from 1 to N. So we will get the same expression. So dummy index can be replaced by any other. So dummy index may be replaced. Dummy index may be replaced by any other index. So now let us interchange the I and J. So we can interchange I is equal to J, J is equal to I. So you will get the same expression. Once if you expand, if you put I is equal to J to N, J is equal to 1 to N, you will get the same expression in the two equations. So interchanging of I and J, we get the result. So so this is after interchanging. Now let us add the 2. This is phi and this is phi. Once we add, the left hand side becomes 2i. Right hand side Aij plus Aij, Aij. AJAI is the same as AAJ. AIAJ is same, is equal to AJAI. So therefore, if you take AAJ as a common term, the result is AIJ plus AGI. So this is the sum. So phi is equal to, you take the 2 here. So this is the result. You AIJ plus AGI by 2, AIAJ. And you call this as a Bij, where Bij is equal to Aij plus Aji. This is a symmetric tensor. So symmetric tensor means what? If you replace I to J, J to I, you will get the same expression. So what is Bij? Bji is equal to Aji plus Aij 4 by 2. So therefore this is a symmetric test. So Bij is equal to Bji. Therefore this is a Bij is a symmetric test. So that is the proof. Now let us consider another example. If Aij is an anti-symmetric tensor of rank 2, Bi is a tensor of rank 1, then show that Aij, Bi, Bj is equal to 0. Aij is a covariant vector of rank 2, and Bi and Bj are the contravariant vector of rank 1. Aij is an anti-symmetric tensor. So in order to prove this one, now let us interchange the dummy indexes Aij, Bi, Bj. So this is a expression. If you interchange, you can interchange because the dummy index can be replaced by any index. So I can be replaced by J, J can be replaced by J. So yeah, dummy index can be replaced by any other index. Here we are interchanging I and J. So we will get this result. But since Aij is an anti-symmetric tensor, this is given. Since it is given, Aji is equal to minus Aij. Therefore, this Aij now becomes minus Aij, Bij. Now you take this term, the other side, this becomes 2Aij, Bi, Bj is equal to 0. Or if you can remove 2, Aij, Bi, Bj is equal to 0. So this can be proved. You consider another example. The mixed tensor Aij is a symmetric in xi coordinate system. This is a symmetric. This given. Find out whether it will be symmetric in any coordinate system or not. So let us consider suppose Aij is a symmetric matrix. This is given. That means Aij must be Aj. So this is symmetric. This is given. Now let us express Aij in the bar system. A alpha beta bar is equal to partial dx alpha bar by partial dxi, partial dxj by dx beta bar into Aij. So now let us express Aij in the bar system. So this is a transformation relation between the unbarred and barred system. Now interchanging alpha and beta. Now here if you interchange alpha beta, this becomes A beta alpha bar. Now in that expression alpha becomes beta. So if you take equation 1 and if we interchange alpha is equal to beta and beta is equal to alpha, you will get this expression. Or A beta alpha bar is equal to partial dx beta bar by partial dxi, partial dx. Before discussing this, we will consider this one. Replacing I to J and J to I, because these are dummy index. I is a dummy index and J is a dummy index. Therefore, in this expression, I can be replaced by J and J can be replaced by I. So that a term becomes like this. So since I and J are dummy indexes, you can write down this one. Now, since Aij is equal to Aji, because it's a given, it's a symmetric tensor. Therefore, that equation Aji is equal to Aij. Now you have to replace this one by so that can be replaced by. So A beta alpha bar is equal to partial dx beta bar by partial dxj, partial dxi by partial dx alpha bar Aij. Now let us compare the right hand side of equation 1 and 2. So here this is 1 and 2. Aij is equal to, so these two are equal. Aij is equal to Aj. This is given. This is given. So the equation, this and this are made equal. But in this side, this is A alpha beta bar. But for this equation 2, this is A beta alpha bar. So these are not equal. So the right hand side of 1 and 2 are not equal. So this A alpha beta bar is equal, not equal to A beta alpha bar. So if A j is a symmetric, this is a known coordinate system. That doesn't mean A alpha bar, alpha beta bar is equal to A beta alpha bar. So if subscript j, superscript I, the contravariant rank is I, covariant rank is j. If you interchange, it is a symmetric, but in the Bode system, it is not symmetric. So A alpha beta bar is not equal to A beta alpha bar. So the property of symmetry or antisymmetry of tensors between a pair of dissimilar indices not invariant. This is but not invariant under coordinate transformation.